In 7 years, over 100 housemates have opened up their lives to the Big Brother cameras. So whatever happened to the first housemate to make headline news?
People believe what they see on television.
Who's made a fortune?
I'm massively successful.
Which housemate is about to change his life forever?
Kind of like a chick with a dick.
It's time to find out. It's been 7 years since the first Big Brother. 10 strangers living together in a house with 27 cameras recording 24 hours a day.
We were 10 innocent fools going into this dilapidated prefab building for 9 weeks. We hadn't a clue.
We thought this will be a late night show. You know, there aren't many viewers that late, and who's going to be interested? Who will find 10 people in a house in Bow interesting?
The weirdest holiday we've ever had.
The first 4 or 5 weeks, people sat around like a tea party. It was like some self-help workshop. And everyone patting themselves on the back and going, brilliant, isn't it great? What would you like some tea? You can get another washing up. Ooh, sorry. And it just became cretinous.
I'm feeling like I want to go home. And I hate being on TV.
Got your dick stuck right up your anus.
Are you afraid
of you? A discussion. You need to learn how to hold one.
But when Nick Bateman was caught cheating, Big Brother changed forever.
Seems like Nick is kind of going round to individuals and kind of getting information.
The rules were you can't discuss nominations, so I wrote them down. It's not breaking the rules, it's kind of bending them, but I think the impact was more outside.
Nick was such a big deal because he broke the rules. And everybody likes to abide by the rules, and us in the house, we survived by you know, living by the rules.
Suddenly thought, my God, he's written notes down. My God, how did he get a pencil? That's interesting. And then I think they felt betrayed.
Nick became front page news.
You dug your own grave. Yeah. You really have dug your own grave.
I can accept that.
He was a creep anyway. Nick was a funny guy. He was just weird. And outside they saw this person cheating.
We decided that we're going to ask you to leave the house.
No inkling to making front page news. There it was. Nasty Nick gets kicked out of the house. Being a villain, you know, everyone hisses and boos at you, which is fine, but, you know, you want to be known for something greater than that.
But Nick used the media storm to his advantage.
I've written a book. I've been in pantomime.
Well, it was all very tragic, really.
On one hand, it opens doors. People know who you are. On the other hand, it closes them as well. And so you get very sore knuckles sometimes and banging on the wrong doors, but it's you know, it's the nature of the beast. Once people meet you, they actually go, "You're not nasty at all. You're totally different." But I think it's the perception that you must be very nasty, and because people believe what they see on television, reality TV people are totally useless, and I think 98% perhaps are. But I think you do get tarred with the same brush. And you have to accept it. There's no point in fighting it. You have to try and prove that you're not just a reality star, that you do have something else to offer.
The relationship between food and stress, and that's at 3:30.
Former nun Anna Nolan has launched her own media career.
I know. Since Big Brother, I have had 2 episodes of a series called Anna in Wonderland. Worked with Davina on 2 series called Closure, a programme called Ask Anna. documentary series called Would You Believe? A live daytime show for 2 years called The Afternoon Show. A documentary series called Flesh and Blood. Several other documentaries. And I'm going to do a programme about sex on the internet.
Winner Craig Phillips went on to star in numerous TV shows and now has a highly successful presenting career. But what happened to the rest? Nicola went from being an art teacher and now works in the adult film industry. Caroline tried unsuccessfully to launch a pop career. Andy moved to Australia but now lives in London working as a brand consultant. Mel works as a newspaper and magazine journalist in East London. Sada wrote a book called The Babe's Bible, trained as a yoga instructor and was last reported to have had twins in Argentina. Claire and Thomas had a son, but they're now separated, and Claire runs a property business in Spain. Darren worked as a TV presenter before briefly training to be a flight attendant. But this was just the beginning. The housemates of the future were about to get bigger, bolder and more outrageous.
You're big brother.
The second series launched a year later, with 11 fresh faces ready to spend their summer in the Big Brother house. The house was bigger, and so were the characters, like Bubble.
My time in the Big Brother house was the most surreal experience of my life.
Narinda.
They keep getting my name wrong. Have they never met an Asian person before? Unashamedly, I am a wannabe. Was then, still am.
And Helen.
Oh my God. Didn't really have any expectations, really. Actually, I didn't really think about it. I just sort of done it.
Now a household name. This was where we first met Irish-born ex-flight attendant Brian Dowling. But even Brian's jokes couldn't stop Tempest fraying.
I'm sick of him! Leave! Baby, now he's a fucking shit!
My argument with Amber, oh God, I mean, it was about nothing.
Smug dick and leave this house because I fucking think you're small, smug and shit! I hate you!
I made her cry, I felt like a wanker for making a girl cry. You can argue with somebody in your confines of your own house, that's all right. But when you do it in front of 5 to 10 million people, it doesn't go down too well.
To go in Big Brother, you have to play a very dishonest game. You have to be very nice all the time. You have to bite your tongue all the time because you're stuck in this house for, what, 12 weeks with people that you wouldn't normally get on with. You know, be small. Mm.
Now living in Oxfordshire, Stuart works as a freelance communications consultant.
My life now has changed massively. I've had some huge highs and lows, and the low was probably getting divorced.
Stuart was the next to be voted out of the house.
Everyone said about this 15 minutes of fame, these are your 15 minutes. I've had this for 6 years now. You know, Big Brother had a massive impact on my life. I've got a great girlfriend who recognised me off of Big Brother. That's how I'm with her. Yeah, so I could thank Big Brother for that.
The relationship between car designer Paul and hairdresser Helen was another highlight of Big Brother 2.
It's just happened, isn't it?
Today, Helen's life has come full circle. Her relationship with Paul, who has gone back to his job in car design, finished back in 2003.
I didn't go in there thinking that I'd end up meeting someone at the time. It's just, you never know what's going to happen to you. Really, we're talking about Paul now because we split up, but in the house we sort of like made a connection and we sort of like got on and everything. And now I still speak to him and we still get on. We probably get on better now as friends. My life now is like ordinary. Like I'm a partner in the salon and everything and it's just all really nice. I work 6 days a week and it's just all really good. Yeah, I enjoy it.
The 11th person to go into the Big Brother house will be...
This year, Big Brother changed the rules by putting in an extra housemate.
There's somebody here.
Enter Josh.
Hi, Josh.
Sort of say,
you could see the work in